We want to find the quotient using the fraction strips provided below, where each fraction strip represents one whole. So here we have 4 1/2, or 4 1/2, divided by 3/4, which means we're trying to determine how many 3/4 are in 4 1/2. Before we consider this specific quotient though, it's sometimes helpful to determine what quotient would be too large and what quotient would be too small compared to the given quotient. This will give us an idea of whether our answer is reasonable. So to determine a quotient that would be too small, we'll divide 4 1/2 by a number that's larger than 3/4, let's say 1. Well, 4 1/2 divided by 1 would just be 4 1/2. And again, since 1 is greater than 3/4, that quotient would be too small. So we'll use 4 1/2 for a quotient that's too small. And then for a quotient that's too large, we'll divide 4 1/2 by a value that's less than 3/4, let's say 1/2. So if we consider 4 1/2 divided by 1/2, again, that's asking us how many halves are in 4 1/2, which would be 9. So taking a moment to determine a quotient that's too large and too small can be helpful, because now we know our quotient should be somewhere between 4 1/2 and 9. Now let's find our quotient. We have 4 1/2 divided by 3/4. So first notice how we have a total of 5 strips, which would be 5. So to begin with 4 1/2, let's cut or denominate this first strip into 2 equal partitions. Let's say here, we would discard this half. So now we have 4 1/2. To determine how many 3/4 are in 4 1/2, we'll now cut or denominate our strips into 4ths, which would look like this. Again, we're discarding this piece here because we're beginning with 4 1/2, not 5. But now because our partitions are 4ths, we can count the number of 3/4 in 4 1/2. So starting at the top, here we have 1, 2, 3/4. So there's one copy of 3/4. Here we have 1, 2, 3/4 again. There's our second copy of 3/4. And we have 1, 2, 3/4 again. There's our third copy of 3/4. 1, 2, 3/4 again. Here's our fourth copy. 1, 2, 3/4. There's our fifth copy of 3/4. And then finally we have 1, 2, 3/4 one more time. So this shows that we have 6 copies of 3/4 in 4 1/2, which means 4 1/2 divided by 3/4 equals 6. So using fraction strips to model division by a fraction can be helpful to conceptualize exactly what's happening. I hope you found this helpful.